奥运期间，各国健儿登上国家新闻头条，打出的标题字眼不外乎是为国增光或是虽败犹荣。但这名荣获的五枚金牌的泳将诺克特和队友，这次却因为在里约街头的恶劣行径成为众矢之的，身败名裂。放眼望去，美国街头报摊上的报章头版主角竟是美国泳队，其中纽约邮报更直接横批诺克特等人是最丑陋的美国人。纽约每日新闻也毫不客气地写明，诺克特本来就是一个麻烦鬼，断然没想过一个谎言会铸成轩然大波，排山倒海而来的舆论压力终于迫使诺克特开枪发文告表明，对自己没有认真和坦白地说出真相，而向全体队友、粉丝、赞助商以及奥运主办方道歉。不过纽约市民显然不买账，舆论普遍谴责诺克特和队友不仅没有以身作则，反而胡乱作为，丢了自己的声誉，还让美国在国际社会抬不起头来。
Yeah, I think you have two kind of ends of the spectrum. One being Ryan Lochte, who's not representing our country really well, and then you have Michael Phelps, who is, you know, not only performing well, but he's a class act, and he's handled all his publicity in a much better way, I think.
I think it's unacceptable. Athletes go and represent their countries in a very important event like the Olympics. They should act very respectful, be very disciplined. And during that 1 month of the Olympics, they should really be very responsible and be acting very, very proper.
另一方面，涉案的其中两名泳将本兹和康格获释，星期五已经从巴西回到迈阿密。由于巴西政府声明依然会传召诺克特问话协助调查，这起风波恐怕会持续发酵。